Hi everyone, this is Harleen Kapoor from Student Visa Network. Today we have Isha with us from Australia. Hi Isha, would you like to please introduce yourself?
Hi Harleen, and thank you for having me. So my name is Isha. I moved to Australia about a year back. I came here on a work permit, so currently I'm working in a company here. Prior to this, I have around 8 to 9 years of experience in India. So yeah, that's a brief.
Can you share your journey with us of moving to Australia?
For me, it wasn't planned. An opportunity came in the way and I thought of taking a leap of faith. So I just went along with it. Journey was a bit challenging emotionally as well as getting used to the things here. Things are very different, people are different, even the work culture is different, but we have to sail along, so.
Yeah, okay. So what initially made you select Australia as your study destination?
I did not study here. I studied in India. Everything I did in India itself. I was applying for jobs in UK because I've seen a lot of movement from India to the UK. And somebody told me that even Australia offers work permit, so I started applying to Australia as well. I also cover how I applied and how I got a job here in my YouTube channel, which is Aussie.Darshan. So basically, I started applying rigorously everywhere that I could. I applied to Dubai, Australia, UK. I got some offers from UK, but I chose Australia because I thought it's a very diverse country. The weather is nice here in Sydney, and I've been to the UK before from my previous organization, but I haven't been to Australia, so I thought it would be a nice breaking the ice kind of a thing to come here. So that's all.
So you have looked for work permit only in other countries as well?
Yeah, the UK was also offering, and even Dubai offers, UAE offers, and Australia. But for me, I thought Australia has a lot of natural habitat and it looks beautiful in photos. So I thought this would be better.
Okay, great. So Isha, what were some of the biggest challenges you faced while transitioning to Australia?
I didn't have family here, nobody, so I did not know the first thing when I landed my foot here. So I did not know how to find a house, where to stay, what is the tax system here, because things, we have different ID cards and tax system is different. So applying for TFN here, everything, figuring out where to buy groceries from, how to arrange things, how to commute, because in India we used to have car, travel around anywhere in a car. Here it's been 1 year, we can't even afford a car. We don't have a car, so we travel by the metro. So figuring out everything, so it's like building a new house or building a new home here from the scratch. So yeah, everything was challenging.
Okay, so were it easy to make friends and build a network in Australia?
There are many Indians here, especially in Sydney, and I have friends in Melbourne and other states too. There are many Indians, so it's easy to connect with them. It's a bit difficult to connect with the foreigners because their language is, their accent is a bit different, and Australian accent is very famous for not being able to understand. Plus, they have their own set of talks. So I'm not able to gel up much with them. Only in office I get to talk to them. But there are many Indians here and very helpful people here. So that's it's easy to make friends here. If it's easy for me, I think the person who is studying in college, it would be very easy for that person to make friends, because there is college is a place where you actually make bonds.
Okay. So can you walk us through your journey or your experience for post-study work visa in Australia?
I haven't studied yet. But my brother is studying in Australia. He's in Adelaide right now. He came on a student visa and he says he's liking it. He had worked in India before. He had 2 years of experience and then he came here. So he's liking it very much. He made good friends. and he's got a part-time job because students can't work full-time. I think there's a limit of 22 to 24 hours. So he kind of balances between the two. So yeah, it's going fine. Not he has his own moments, but it's fine.
Okay. So you can tell us about your experience about work visa in Australia to our audience.
I would say that it's not very easy to get. It is difficult and it depends on what line of work you are working in. For IT, it is still, I mean, achievable. For the other fields, like I would say, for example, many people ask me on my YouTube videos for carpentry, for electrician. I don't think they easily offer work permit from some other country. But for IT, I say that they many countries, not even Australia, they do offer work permits. Yeah. So it's not easy, but it is possible.
Okay. So what do you advise to our students who are considering to stay in Australia after completing their studies?
It's a very nice country to stay in, honestly. I mean, it's very expensive, so be prepared for that. When I got here, I got the shock of my life. But you can also earn here. I've seen many students earning really good, even Uber cab drivers, they really earn good. And I mean, the minimum wage here is $24 per hour, which is maximum across almost, I think, even it's twice what they pay in USA. So if you're worried about, you know, how you would manage here in terms of finances, I think there's a job here for everybody. It's only that you really have to try hard because now there are many immigrants coming in and the market is really full. But there are good chances of you being able to settle down here if you're mentally prepared and ready for it.
Okay. So what is the job market in Australia for international graduates?
If you're already studying and you want a part-time job, you can only work as a part-time job because you don't get full hours. So I don't think there are many, office kind of jobs that you can get a hand of because they want you to work full time. But restaurants, I've seen some of my brother's friends working in restaurants and they are driving cabs and then they are doing food delivery. So those kind of jobs for 22 hours per week or 24 hours per week, you can easily get those and they do pay well.
Okay, so are there any particular industry they are welcoming international students?
In terms of job?
In terms of job, yes.
Once you get graduated, you get full hours. So then it depends on what study, what your study area is. For example, if you're studying in IT, then the respective companies who have that job opening, they would be ready to hire you. If you're studying engineering, then engineering construction companies would be ready to hire you. So it depends on what you're studying. If you're doing a cookery course, suppose. So it all depends on what course you are selecting.
Okay. Can you share some tips for international students for job hunting in Australia?
There are many, not many, 3-4 sites which I find very helpful. First one is LinkedIn, Indeed.com, Jora, Gumtree. So four of these are very nice. Even there's one more site, which is Grad Connection, which is basically for graduates only. So it posts job for entry-level people. So those are very good. I mean, there are many jobs that come up, keep applying almost every week. I mean, dedicate 1 hour for applying.
So student can easily find jobs on these websites, which you have mentioned.
Everything is online, so you can find everything online. You don't need to personally go anywhere, so all the jobs are there. Like we have in India too, Naukri, Indeed. We don't now go to the companies asking for them.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. So how would you rate the cost of living in Australia?
It is expensive. Sydney, it's considered one of the most expensive cities, so it is very expensive. Transport itself is very expensive. My one side commute to office, which is like 40 minutes from here, is $6.2, which is around, and round trip takes around 1200 rupees. So it is pretty expensive. But other cities, like my brother is living in Adelaide, that is comparatively cheaper. In terms of renting an apartment, grocery, I wouldn't say. Grocery, I think, is more or less same because the giant supermarkets, they have almost the same prices.
Okay, so So can you give some tips to our students to how to manage expenses in Australia?
Keep a budget. I mean, firstly, when you come here, it will take you easily 2-3 months to find a job. Easily 2-3 months, because you will run from pillar to post searching for the right job. So once you have that, here you get paid weekly. So once you have that weekly income coming in, then you half of that income normally goes into rent easily. Mm-hmm. So half of that goes into rent, then 50-60 goes into groceries, then transport. So I mean, have that segregation. Mm-hmm. And you will know what you're left with. You also need to enjoy, because you're in a different country. You have to, what's the point of coming here if you don't enjoy? Exactly. So yeah, have that segregation.
Okay, so what are some common pathways for students to transition into student visa to permanent resident visa?
So I think for student, once you come on 485 student visa, then you get the graduate visa, temporary graduate visa, which is for 3 years. So many of the people I've talked with, once their 3 years are getting over, they normally talk to their employers. They normally file for your permanent residency. If they are not willing, then they normally file for a sponsored visa, which is a work visa, which is 482. Visa. So if you're good at what you're doing, they would be ready to sponsor you. If not, then you can file for a PR yourself too, if your points are adding up to the limit.
Okay. So what are the current immigration changes in Australia? Can you please enlighten some details about that as well?
I am not sure, not an immigration agent, but yeah, the Australian government is very fickle-minded. It keeps changing things, and it's making difficult for international students here.
Okay. So do you have any idea about the scholarship offered to international students?
Many universities do. For example, even my brother, he applied to a couple of universities, and from many universities he got around 30-40% scholarship. So they check basically their percentage, academics, extracurricular. It is not necessary that every university would offer you, but it depends on what university is, what course you are opting for, does the course match your experience or background. So basis on that, there are many parameters which they never reveal, but on the basis of which they provide some scholarship.
So how competitive they are, I mean, how easily it is for international students to get the scholarship? It's totally on the academic criteria.
It also depends on experience. For example, after your college in India, if you've worked for 2-3 years, then that definitely helps, because you're already skilled. Yeah. And then you're doing a similar course here, then they would obviously appreciate that. So they calculate everything, your background, if you're good in sports, all of those things they do ask. So yeah.
Okay, so what would be your 3 pieces of advice for someone who is planning to study or work in Australia?
Firstly, look at the pros and cons. Grass is always greener on the other side. It's not. I've seen people actually coming here and then going back as well. So see what your priorities are. Second, once you make up your mind, look for the right course if you are coming here on a study visa. Because the course matters, and half of the jobs here posted have a prerequisite of the course. I mean, they want the course, and only then you would be required to, I mean, you would be allowed to kind of be considered for the job. Third is that try to find a job when you're working part-time. It is difficult, that kind of aligns with your course, so that when you're studying, that kind of, you know, adds up to your experience too. So when you are already graduated, you already have 2-3 years of experience working part-time. So yeah.
Okay. So Isha, how important is for working professionals to know about the visa and immigration regulations?
It is very important, because they keep making changes to the immigration process now and then. Australian government is famous for that. So obviously, I mean, it's like you have to stay updated, because you never know when you might need or when that change would impact you. So
exactly. So we should know about the details about what changes or what.
Even I keep following the rules about that.
Okay, so how do you see future of international students in Australia as per your prospects?
I think it depends from person to person. If you're strong-willed, then definitely it depends on you. I mean, Australia does provide an opportunity to everybody who's coming here. Now they've strict, I mean, the rules are becoming strict for international students. They've put a lot of regulations here and then, but if you do manage to come here and if you are strong-willed, then it will be difficult, but you will get there.
Isha, can you tell about the student support services in Australia for international students, or are there any societies or social groups for the immigrant students?
No official social groups that I've heard of, but there are many groups on Facebook. For example, Sydney International Students, I know for Sydney it's there. So likewise, my brother also tells me that when he wasn't able to find an apartment on Facebook, there were many groups for Adelaide that he joined and they helped them out. And then there are many Indians, people are helpful here, not even Indians, even people who are foreigners here, not even Australian people, who, because many people are immigrants, people who come from different countries. All of those people are very helpful here. So, yeah.
Okay. So, Isha, like we all have heard that there is racism in Australia. So, you being there in Australia, can you let us know that, is that true or this is...
I haven't faced any racism, at least if people have it in their... Maybe people are keeping it in their hearts, but they are not speaking it out, but nobody has said anything to me as of now. So yeah, and I think it's not easy to say things which are that sensitive here because there are strict laws. So till now, hopefully nobody says that to me. All good till now.
So definitely one of the most asked questions: what are the travel destinations students can travel in their free time?
It depends on what state you are opting for. For example, I am in NSW, whose capital is Sydney. So all of Australia is very beautiful, and Sydney is like the prime location, Harbour Bridge, Opera House, and then even if you go to the outskirts, it's very beautiful. I went to Adelaide to visit my brother. Even Adelaide is very beautiful. It's a regional, it's a regional city, but it's not like, it's not a gaon. I mean, it is proper, it is very developed. So irrespective of which state you opt for, I think there are just 5 or 6 states that people generally go to. I mean, cities that people go to. Sydney, Melbourne and Brisbane are the most sought after. And then we have the regional ones. Perth is booming. Adelaide is booming, even Sunshine Coast is. I've heard a lot about it. That it's there are many job openings there. So yeah.
Okay. Before wrapping up, would you like to give any tips to our students who are planning to visit or who are planning to travel to Australia?
If you can afford to come here, because I think they've increased the fees for student visa, the student fees, it has increased a lot. So try for scholarship because they do offer scholarships here. And if you are easily able to get 30 to 40% discount, then why not try for it? And when you come here, I would say don't just think of earning money for the sake of, paying back to your parents or, for the sake of just minting money. Actually study, because after studying the course, when you get a good job, that would be way more beneficial than doing those odd jobs or those short-lived jobs to earn money at that moment. Because I've seen many people who do not go to their colleges, who do not attend classes, and then at the end of the course they've learned nothing and they when they go for a job, they do not get any job for that course that they did. So yeah, have a strong mind, strong will, and yeah, that's all.
Thank you so much, Tisha, for your time and giving such an informative session to our audience. And thank you everyone for watching our podcast. Do like, share and subscribe our podcast, and you can contact us at hello@rbsintellect.com. Thank you, Isha.
Thank you. And I would like to add that I have my YouTube channel too, ausi.darshan, Aussie.darshan. So please subscribe to me as well. Thank you so much.